dangerous games we used to play in the ruins of this city. Falling out of bombed-out buildings. Trying to fly model planes that wouldn't fly. Throwing stones at Russian tanks. Now you go on playing these dangerous games, one foot in the east, one in the west. I look back now at those adventures and I shudder. Which is, I suppose, why I am no longer suitable for employment in the field. Who are you hiding from today with your healthy paranoia?
One of Frank Harrington's people.
Would Frank Harrington have somebody following him?
That bloody old man is in a panic. The Whisper says there's a leak in Berlin, so he flaps around to make sure it's nothing to do with him. Alter Trottel. Frank's tired. All he thinks about now is his pension. He doesn't even hate communists anymore. Is there a leak?
There is no leak.
Good. I'll tell Rolf Mauser it's just his paranoia, shall I? See what I mean? Sitting on me day and night. Frank's really put the boot in, hasn't he? Even the Americans won't use me these days. Sitting on Checkpoint Charlie with you last night for the first operational contact I have had in 5 years.
Have you actually asked Berlin Field for a job?
On my knees to Frank Harrington, never.
Why so hard on Frank? Perhaps he misconstrues some of your extramural activities. He might imagine a little discreet black market here and there, set up with Liesl's life savings.
Don't mother me, please, Bernie.
Ah, Schulem. Ihren Ausweis, bitte.
Pretty girl. Your daughter?
Open it up.
Not that, it's mine.
I don't care if it belongs to Herbert von Karajan.
But I do, since it happens to belong to a senior British Army officer.
You have identification?
Yes.
I would get your identification brought up to date if I were you, Major Bishop. Expired 3 months ago.
Scheiß Nazi. Running around, licking Frank Harrington's boot polish and chasing Jews. I've been drinking beer in here for 30 years. Wedding present from Liesl?
Still in Munich?
She called me last week. Wanted to know how I was.
How were you?
What the hell would you feel if it was Fiona?
Well, what is Major Bishop supposed to be carrying in his briefcase?
$500,000 Swiss franc, a newspaper.
Wow.
Been sightseeing, Major Bishop.
It was you then.
Was me what?
Setting the dogs on Werner.
Werner's beginning to think you closed the doors against him.
Beginning to think? Werner was blackballed after the Karlshorst affair. We made an intercept on Karlshorst for the very first time, but somehow it was reported back to the Russians. Werner was in charge of communication security that night. Well, I'm sure it wasn't deliberate. But Werner was the leak's source. Why didn't you ask Stu Brody? I called him in to carry out the investigation.
Is that why Joe Brody's here tonight, to put the finger on Werner?
Well, Joe's an old friend, Bernard. Goes back a long way.
Thought it was you, Samson.
Yeah, I know, I know. What the hell am I doing back in Berlin?
Come to check up on Frank, I should hope. He has quite a collection, isn't he? Worth a pretty packet, Samson.
Still on the Berlin staff, then, Joe?
No, I never was. I'm only a part-timer in your games. Always have been.
Do you remember anything about the Carl's horse business, Joe?
I'd have known you had an ulterior motive, Frank.
Is Carl's horse a genuine leak, or...?
Never was proved, one way or another.
Who were the suspects?
Everyone in the building. I gave Joe a free hand. I didn't want the Yanks to think we were covering anything up.
How did the finger come to point at Werner Faulkman?
Process of elimination.
How many people were involved?
I had the whole office on duty that night. Staff on two shifts. Brett, Werner, Fiona, myself.
Is Giles Trent around?
Trent? He was FCO.
The Foreign Office guy? No. No chance of pinning it on him. The way I understood it, he had no access to the building.
You can remember it so well.
Sure. Took a little time to dig Trent's file out of London, but he was clear. In fact, if I remember correctly, everyone cleared on file except Werner Faulkman.
Yes, well, it stands to reason, doesn't it? Werner didn't have a London clearance. Doesn't mean to say he was a Soviet agent, though.
Like I said, nothing was proved one way or the other. There were no charges made, officially.
But unofficially, he was given the boot.
I think I should explain, Joe. Bernard was at school with Werner Faulkman.
Your loyalty does you credit, Samson.
Thank you, Joe.
Jesus, I know guys in your position would be trying to pin it on their wives.
So, guten Tag. Street name and number.
Okay. What if I lose my job on Monday?
Hello, you old English whore! Hey!
My father gets the best of both worlds. Social justice in the East, decadence in the West, and duty-free in no man's land.
Hey. I heard you were here, Bernd. I had to come over and see you. Here, a drink to old Yuri, wherever he is. They say he shot out the lights for you. We were set up, Bernd. I just want to be sure you don't think it was anything that I might have said.
No.
So there's someone in London trying to flush us out. Your old Brahms network. Oh, don't worry about him. He doesn't even know who Beethoven is.
I thought I knew Berlin like a dentist knows a patient's mouth. Lubars. Trust Frank Harrington to house his mistress in the one part of the city that looks like Ascot.
Are you all right?
Oh,
I've got... Sure.
Tut dir was weh?
Nein.
Alles okay? Kannst du Nase fahren?
Gut.
Well.
Yeah, it's a very black.
Yeah.
There is my house. You want to wash them?
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome.
You speak English very well.
You have to. In this town...
Do you know this is the first time I've been out to Lubars? It's amazing, isn't it? 20 minutes from the city center, and you're right out in the country.
If it wasn't for the wall all around us, whichever way we turn. Would you like some coffee?
Yes, please.
You get used to it.
Not everyone does.
My grandfather was in Berlin once and couldn't stop looking at the wall. He used to have a farm in East Prussia, 800 kilometers from Berlin. And it was still in Germany. Do you know how far from here Poland is now? Less than 60.
Thank you. That's very good coffee.
I have it delivered from Cadivé.
You don't get into town too often, then? It must get a bit lonely out here.
It does. I also get very bored.
I'm a friend of Frank's. I work with him.
Frank Harrington?
Is anyone Frank in Berlin?
Do you have a message from him? Is something wrong?
I hope not.
You didn't tell me your name.
You see, Frank's in a very sensitive job. And sometimes that means checking up on him and on his closer friends. Or companions. He'd have a lot of explaining to do about a house in Lubars. How long have you been here?
I don't have to answer your questions.
Not yet.
What do you mean?
Well, if it comes to an official inquiry, you will have to answer all questions, Mrs. Volkmann.
Did Frank give you my name?
Frank doesn't even know I'm here.
What is your name?
I'd rather we kept his private life private. You know, I mean, how would he feel? Young men in his own office. I mean, to compile reports on who you are, where you go, people you meet, how much money you've got in a bank account. Other men you might have met in previous escapades.
You still haven't told me your name.
No, I haven't, Mrs. Faulkner. It's Samson, Bernard Samson.
What a very professional spy you are, Mr. Bernard Samson. I wonder how Werner would feel if he knew where his great friend was and what he was doing.
And where does Werner think you are?
I imagine that is a tricky question.
Coca-Cola driver with the big truck. I'd really love to know how that works. Is it a friend of yours sending Werner postcards from Munich? I can't believe he'd fall for that old trick. Or is it Frank helping out with one of our couriers when he's not at home with his wife and family, that is?
Frank might be an inconsiderate bastard some of the time, but he's a real man, Mr. Sampson.
And Werner is not.
Oh, I know he's your friend. And you hold hands together in the pram. And watch the wall being built. I know all of that. But you try. And live with him for a year. And find out what he's really like. He can't make up his mind about anything at all.
A very strange life you must lead, Mrs. Faulkner. Having all your coffee delivered from Cardi Bay because you don't go into town in case you bump into your own husband.
Frank will get you kicked out of the service for this.
I wouldn't mention any of this to Frank if I were you. I mean, if it comes to an official inquiry, he'll probably lose his job and his pension. And if that happens, he might turn around and think it's all your fault.
You bastard!
Only doing my job.
So was Eichmann.
Well, I'm sure you know more about German history than I do, Mrs. Volkmann, so I'll just have to take your word for that.
Get out! Get out!
Not with you, then.
Hello. Hello, darling. Are you calling me from Berlin? Oh. No, she's not. I think she said she was taking the kids to see your mother. Of course I'm alone, darling. George is still in Rome waiting for his audience. Bye. My brother-in-law.
He's been in Berlin.
That's probably an official secret.
Well, I am official, darling, aren't I? Why was he phoning you?
Looking for his wife and family. You wouldn't know the feeling, Giles.
My intention is to upgrade the entire Brahms operation.
If you don't lose it altogether.
An upgrade would give me an extra undersecretary. I was rather thinking in terms of your expertise. And the pleasure it would be to work with you more closely. Over to mine.
574164. Hello? Did the trip go well?
I did what I was told.
Not you, darling. You never do what you're told.
Fast running, children.
I did ring, you know, several times from Berlin, but you were never in. I mean, I wouldn't want you to think I hadn't called.
Well, I must have been out. Well, how was Berlin?
Out every evening, then, were you?
Well, Frank Harrington telexed about the leak. Everyone's running around like headless hens, vetting, counter-vetting. Did you find out anything in Berlin? All right, I didn't ask.
Brett today, he was vetting you, was he?
I was invited there for lunch, Bernie, with the children.
Vetting them as well, I suppose.
Darling, I was told you're expected back on Monday. I thought you'd be spending today with Werner. Otherwise, of course, I wouldn't have gone away.
Werner's the last person I would have been spending today with in the circumstances.
What circumstances?
Circumstances of not believing a bloody word anyone's telling me.
You rang, didn't you? This afternoon at Brett's. And I answered the phone and you hung up on me. But you'd have been in time to come down and join us if you'd opened your mouth, said hello. What's the matter with you? Do you think I'm having an affair with Brett Rensselaer? Is that where your paranoia has led you? Well, damn you to hell.
You were sent to Berlin to pick up Brahms 4, and yet you made no attempt to clear it through me. What in hell did you imagine you were going to do with him?
We didn't know it was Brahms 4, Brett.
But if it was?
German desk has responsibility for border crossings. So I'll fan the shitheads if anything goes wrong.
That's your problem. Brahms Network is my desk, Richard. Don't you ever forget that. So, no Brahms 4. Who did you see?
Werner Volkmann, Rolf Mauser.
Did you go over?
I'm not in the field, Brett. I'm not authorized to cross the wall.
You didn't tell Frank this leaked material was genuine.
Frank really doesn't give a damn whether it's genuine or not, just so long as it doesn't come dribbling out of his Berlin office.
A bit hard on Frank, aren't you?
Does he understand the implications? If our people on the other side get to know the leaks from London, they'll start running like rabbits.
Frank believes that that's the intention of leaking the leaks back to us. They're going for Brahms.
You, wouldn't have a penciled in name for the leak?
Mr. Giles Trent.
Giles? Known him forever. You'll be wasting your time there, old boy. The report will be with the DG tomorrow.
All right. But I warn you, Bernard. You go behind my back just once more, I'll rip your balls off.
Bring the papers home. They can't all be classified.
Where are you?
Charles Trent, Foreign Office. Played cricket for Blue Mantles. Belongs to Whitehall, but trespasses regularly. Knocks off an awful lot of secretaries.
You're quite a little gumshoe, aren't you? I begin to worry how much you know about me.
Do you want me to come with you? Catch the pieces when you throw them out the window.
Call the duty officer, Julian. Get him to send a couple of minders. Whoever's on the roster.
Okay. It's all right. I stuck a wedge in the door last time someone went in.
Go home, Julian.
How the devil did you get in?
I'm a member of the Magic Circle.
If Fiona sent you here to talk about Tessa, you can forget it. It's none of your damn business. In fact, nothing I do could be any of your damn business.
I saw you on the plane last week, flying into Tegel.
You mean to tell me you've come here in the middle of the night to give me a bloody parking ticket?
Did you have authorization to go over the wire into the east?
I went to see the Berliner Ensemble and for a meal at the Ganymede.
You'd have been ID'd at Charlie and picked up long before you got anywhere near the Ganymede. Unless, of course, they were expecting you. Were you in the Cards Club tonight?
Yes.
Talking with a member of the Russian embassy staff?
It's a chess club. I play with all kinds of people. I don't ask what they do for a living.
I think he was KGB, don't you?
The Russian is a friend of my sister's. They met at the opera.
Oh. Listen, I don't want to feel that Berlin is part of my life anymore. This is my home. You're my home.
Works against us all the time. The secrecy, the paranoia, and knowing each time you're in danger.
I sprung a little mole tonight.
The mole?
Giles Trent.
Giles? Oh, I don't believe it.
You're not the only one who won't.
But where on earth does that leave Tessa?
Under interrogation from the heavies at MI5, she's not very careful.
Oh, my God. And Giles is hardly a little mole, is he? He's an FCO undersecretary.
He fell rather too easily into the net, I thought.
Well, what do you mean?
Remember the Karlsruhe intercept, yes?
Well, how could I ever forget?
Was Giles Trent actually in the Berlin office the night Carl's horse leaked?
You remember Giles, darling. He was up there every night for coffee to see if any of the girls wanted to lift back into town.
Yeah, but can you remember him being in the office that particular evening?
Yes. Frank had us all working late. So Giles didn't get to give anyone a lift. He was quite miffed. You mean you think Karlshorst could have been leaked by him? Ah, I suppose that might make sense. It would also let Werner off the hook, wouldn't it? Did you see Werner?
Yeah.
And this new wife of his?
Oh, she's done a bunk.
Not already?
Coca-Cola salesman from Munich with a very big truck. Actually, I found her shacked up with Frank Harrington.
What?
Couldn't quite work out whether Werner knew about it or not.
I could have had an affair with Brett Rensselaer.
Love you.
Yeah. Okay. Giles Trent. You think it's suicide?
Hold his head. Is there some better light?
There are no more lights. He likes the dark. Giles.
Water. Too much. Stop. I should be done in a hospital.
Okay, what the hell happened?
I should be asking you that question. You made a quasi-arrest without any form of authorization. Poor old Giles, he could hammer you if he has a mind.
Poor old Giles, is it?
One has to assume your interrogation went way over the top.
My interrogation served its purpose, Dickie. An attempted suicide is as good as a confession in my book.
And his sister's in there with him.
How did she turn up?
She lives around the corner.
Don't quite understand who you all are.
You must be aware that your brother worked in the Foreign Office.
Yes.
And that some of his work was classified. We have to find out why this happened.
It happened because of whatever happened last night.
Yes, well, we're going to get your brother into a nice, comfortable room with medical attention on tap.
I think I have some rights as his next of kin to make that decision myself.
The ambulance will be here in a moment. I wonder, could I trouble you to put some of his things into a case and bag? Just enough for a few days.
I'm going with him.
Well, if you like, I'll phone the office and ask. They almost always say no. It's the trouble with getting anything done at this time of the morning. None of the really senior people can be found.
I thought you were senior.
Yes, exactly. That's what I mean. There'll be nobody senior enough to countermand my orders.
Poor Giles. Through working for people like you. Was it you here with him last night?
Married in opera, but not in Seville. Six letters. Any ideas?
I know nothing about opera. I hate opera. Besides, that's not the crossword. That's the classifieds you're pretending to read.
I'm just looking for another job.
Coming home?
Yeah.
How's the suicide?
He'll survive.
I don't care whether he lives or dies. So long as he doesn't drag Tessa into all this mess. Can you keep her out of it?
Rather depends on Tessa. Is she sleeping with him?
How do you define sleeping? Especially with Tessa. If the department finds out, they'll send someone round asking questions. And then George is sure to get to know about it. He's back from Rome tomorrow.
Poor George.
He's such a silly sweetie.
Funny, isn't it? It's the cuckolded husbands rather than the guilty parties that seem to lose face these days. You smell good.
I've been to the cabinet office. The nicer you smell, the more favors you get.
Does that rule apply for husbands as well?
I'll give it a try. I do love you.
Nice to see you again, Mr. Sampson.
Ted Riley. God. How are you? I don't believe it. How's the family?
Bright and shining. Now listen to you. I hear you've been back to Berlin. You getting your hands dirty again?
Oh, well, I'm just a messenger boy these days, Ted.
Makes two of us. This way. Shunted out into the sidings with our wheels getting rusty, eh? Tell us this. How is the old place?
Well, it's not so old anymore, Ted. I mean, there are bits of Berlin that even you wouldn't recognize.
I'd know the people. That would be enough.
Frau Hennig?
Liesl. Ach, I don't suppose you'd remember me now.
Oh, she asked after you.
You bloody kids. You're a shoving lot, the whole lot of you.
One half of a damn good football team.
Aye, but only when your dad was the referee. See the new governor here? Terrible man for protocol. Need rotten permission to take a leak these days.
Huh? Listen, Ted, I'm sorry to land you with an invalid.
That's all right. Glad I have a wee bit extra to do for a change. Been freewheeling all winter. Just the odd residential training course now and again, that's all.
What do you think about Mr. Trent?
Foreign office, isn't he? Well, if you ask me, I think he's a whining wee man who has lost his bottle. Do you know he spent all day yesterday crying?
Do you think he'll give me a written confession?
Well, if he doesn't, you let me have a go at him, he bloody soon will. After you. I'll tell you something else, son. He'd be far better doing what you want him to do than been handed over to Five. Visitor for you, Mr. Trent.
I do wish you'd stop trying to pretend this was some kind of luxury hotel. You've got a nerve. This is bloody kidnapping. I don't care what Dickie Cryer says.
Well, you're taking an overdose of sleeping tablets. Made him very upset.
You're a sardonic bastard.
Yes.
I warn you, I shall throw habeas corpus at you with a vengeance.
Oh, ordinary citizens don't get habeas corpus these days, Trent. I wouldn't give much for your chances.
Don't play policeman with me, Sampson. I'm an undersecretary at the Foreign Office.
You're a spy. A rather grubby little spy. If I was playing policeman, I'd be telling you that Tessa has made a full and frank confession.
Tessa?
Yes, Tessa. Krasinski, my sister-in-law, whom you're currently humping.
Don't be so bloody offensive.
You spent your life humping other men's women and never taking responsibility for a partner yourself. I find that rather offensive.
What has Tessa told you?
Nothing. As far as I'm concerned, she's not involved. You'd do well to remember that.
I demand access to a lawyer.
Fart in a thunderstorm, Trent. You gave up what citizens' rights you have when you signed the Official Secrets Act. I can do anything I bloody well want with you, and nobody will ask any questions.
I have a family.
You have one sister who's heavily implicated in this mess.
She's not involved.
But you are.
What precisely do you suppose you're going to get out of me?
The truth. Anything that seems less than the truth, and your sister will be pulled in. It wouldn't be difficult to build a case against her.
Whatever I did, it amounted to very little.
What were your contact procedures?
A phone call when I had something to hand over.
And the drop?
A payphone on Liverpool Street Station.
And the chess club?
Sometimes. Usually when he wanted to specify information they needed.
His name was Kolesnikov.
He worked as a driver for the Soviet trade delegation.
Oh, don't make jokes like that, Trent. You had me falling off my chair with laughter. Like Cherubino.
Who?
The Marriage of Figaro. I discovered your sister has no interest whatsoever in opera, and yet you said she'd met Kolesnikov at the opera.
She liked him, not Mozart.
You're seriously telling me that you've been trading classified information with the Russians to keep your sister serviced by a KGB guerrilla?
Look, she was in love with him.
She is in love with him. Look, it may sound odd to you, but that's the truth.
To me, it sounds rather silly and squalid. But I do have to warn you that to MI5, you will sound comically implausible.
Who said anything about MI5? How can I keep my sister out of this?
I don't know.
Perhaps by pretending nothing has happened.
You stay where you are at your Foreign Office desk and carry on leaking selected items to Kolesnikov. Selected by us, of course.
Will I go home?
Under surveillance.
And what if they find out?
The Russians? They'll be very angry and unpredictable.
What happens if I refuse to cooperate? I end up at the Old Bailey.
You're too far up the ladder for a public trial. Muddy too much water, wouldn't it? The newspapers would crucify us.
So what happens?
Well, I imagine you'll end up in the ambulance with the blue flashing lights that doesn't quite make it to the emergency ward in time. Well, lunchtime. Give it some thought over the tin carrots.
Nobody knows where you are. Now, you smile at Mr. Rensselaer, Mr. Sampson, and you'll maybe get to ride in his nice big motor car. Don't suppose he picked that up on a department salary, eh?
His family owns a bank, Ted. It's rather out of our league, I'm afraid.
Help yourself.
No thanks.
Brahms 1 is out.
Out how, where?
Took Frankfurt a day and a half to get one of our own people through West German red tape to talk to him. He's going on and on about a leak. Seems to be terrified.
Well, you'd be terrified after 15 years of waiting for the knock on the door at midnight.
It's still classified.
He had to be very frightened, didn't he? To abandon his wife and children.
We need to break this, Trent, Bernard.
Break?
A confession. We have to show our people that the leak has been plugged. Otherwise, Brahm's network is going to dissolve in front of our eyes. Is he cracking?
Brett, we're leaking out of the top of the bucket. What access could Trent possibly have had?
He's an undersecretary at the Foreign Office.
So?
That's high enough for me. And for the newspapers when we subpoena him.
But you and I know it's not high enough. It's too bloody neat, Brett. I mean, we discover a leak, and hey presto, there's Giles Trent, ready, plucked and trussed, like a quail with his legs in the air.
And if it's not him?
Well, it could be any one of us, couldn't it?
I'd like your assurance that in the event you'd be prepared to go over and talk with Brahms IV. Persuade him to stay, at least until we can manage to maneuver another source into position. Seems you're the only one he's prepared to talk to. After all, you set the network up. You and Yuri Rostov. You're going to abandon them all?
5 years ago, I abandoned Yuri Rostov in a minefield to protect your Brahms network. You bust me from the field, remember? Why do you suppose I'd go back to do you a favor?
How many contacts did you have?
Kolesnikov.
He was the only one? Did he leave you a phone number to ring in case anything went wrong?
We never discussed the possibility of my being caught.
They gave you no goodbye codes?
No.
That depends. When's your next meeting scheduled?
Tomorrow evening.
Tell him you're writing a report on the Berlin system. The whole Berlin network. Every damn thing we do over there.
Never even heard of the Berlin system.
Oh, you will. And it'll make Comrade Kolesnikov happy.
Na, du alter Gangster.
Du, hat mich jemand beschattet?
Nein, nur ich.
Also, Brahms 1 steigt aus. Jemand hat ausgepackt. Die anderen werden alle ganz verrückt vor Angst.
Aber was glaubst du, wie sie sich erst fühlen, wenn sie sehen, dass du abhaust?
Ich hau ja nicht ab. Solange Brahms funktioniert, habe ich noch mit Geschäftliches zu erledigen. Du, besorg mir mal einen Flug.
Na, du fängst an, ganz schön teuer zu werden.
Let's talk about 1980. December 1980.
I was in Berlin.
Yes. Remember something called the Karlshorst Intercept?
We were interrogated about it for nearly a week. Of course I remember. There was a Warsaw Pact flap on. Poland or something. Apparently we nobbled their radio traffic for a couple of nights.
Until our nobble was leaked back to Moscow.
Foreign Office knew nothing about the intercept. We weren't even allowed into operations.
Didn't stop you visiting each evening, though, did it?
Not that evening. Perhaps you've forgotten the sight and sound of Frank Harrington in full flap. I could hear him from the other side of the compound. I went nowhere near the place that night.
I was told that you were seen there that night.
Look, I played this scene out a dozen times with that CIA missionary Frank pulled in on us. Joe...
Brody.
Brody. Ask him. It'll still be on file. I went nowhere near the place that night.
All right, off the record.
Off the record, on the record. It makes no difference. I didn't go up to operations. Whoever told you I did has either forgotten... or is lying.
Billy? They look fine. Darling.
Hello. Fiona.
George, darling. How's the Pope? Did he sell you absolution?
10 years since paid, courtesy of American Express.
He's a useless client for Rome, darling.
He never does sin. George, let me buy you a drink.
Cheers, Tess.
Cheers.
How long have you been screwing Giles Trent?
Devil has on four.
You're the biggest child of all, Tess. How long's it been going on?
A few weeks.
Where did you meet him for the first time?
Darling, I don't know. I can't remember. It was years ago. An 8-week party at Oxford.
All part of the same group? Fiona as well.
I only knew the Oxford gang because she was there.
When did you actually sleep with him for the first time?
Bernie?
Listen, he's under surveillance. You can end up in the witness box at the Old Bailey answering some very embarrassing questions. So next time you see him, bye-bye. Okay?
Any minute now. Whee! What on earth did you say to Tessa? She looked like you'd hit her with a snake. I only said talk to her, darling.
Cheers, sweetie. Giles Trent doesn't have any good buy codes.
So?
Well, the Russians always like to give their agents an emergency exit. Things go wrong, they like to get him home. That's the way they work.
You mean you think he's not a Russian agent?
I mean Moscow has no intention of getting him out.
Georgie Porgie put in her pot, kissed the girls and made them cry. When the girls came out to play, Georgie Porgie ran away.
Guess what I got?
What have you
guess
got?
What I got? Oh, did you get some of the rest from me? Who's that sweet chicken?
Yeah, I got that.
Did you? Did you?
Bernard. A German voice. He won't say who he is.
What the hell are you doing here?
Take it easy, Bernd. Did you bring the money?
You have no authority to be out of Berlin.
Money, Bernd. Save your lectures for young Werner. If Brown's Four goes kaput, we will be closed down. The Brahms network is the best in Berlin.
Maybe the network's falling apart because you're a load of bloody geriatrics.
Oh, you have no feelings anymore.
Maybe you've been running the network, using it for black market deals on the other side, and the Voppers are getting tired of you all.
You think we don't know about the KGB spy here in London going to blow us any minute? £400, I asked Bernd.
Why?
To buy someone off. You want to save the Brahms network? I know a way of doing it.
With £400?
Shopping, Bernard. Stilton and smoked salmon. And don't tell me it's late at night. I know that all London senior staff have £500 at home for emergencies. I am an emergency.
Is there only one thing to be done with a signed confession? Acknowledge the idiot's telling the truth and try to establish whether that truth be his whole truth. How did you fall upon him? Name out of a hat, was it? That's the way we used to do it in the old days. The very old days. It seemed the only fair way to do it. Seemed we were all chums. Name out of a hat.
Mr. Trent made an unauthorized and unnecessary visit to East Berlin, sir, at the time of the leak. He used Tegel Airport and Checkpoint Charlie. Now, I imagine someone must have told him that if he kept his eyes shut, he'd be invisible.
What do you mean, unnecessary?
This Russian in London. You saw them together, did you?
With a backup pair.
How can you be so sure?
Because they had snow in their boots, Dickie. No, I'm sorry. That was meant as a serious remark. I think the Russians staged the whole thing.
Why should they stage it?
At Balliol together, weren't you, you and this Trent?
Yes.
Not a good advertisement for the old establishments, is it? Next time he's in debrief, you'd better go along and hold his hand. You'll be able to talk about old chums together. What about this how do you pronounce it?
Klestikov, sir.
Klestikov.
He has a pre-arranged meeting with Trent tonight, sir. You see, we're trying to hook them on the idea that Trent is preparing to leak the Berlin system.
Is Samson running this show on his own?
German desk is running it. It's Bernard's file.
Glass of sherry. Simpson. Close it all. Help yourself.
Thank you.
Oh. There's another Soviet sleeper in my department.
I didn't exactly say that, sir.
Care to me as parrot's piss. You believe the KGB fed us Trent in order to protect another more important source.
It's a possibility.
Sit down. What's their next move?
They're making a heavy play for Brahms' network. Whoever it is in London does not know the identity of Brahms 4. I think whoever it is may soon have to step out of the shadows and be seen. If we happen to be looking in the right direction at the right time.
Any idea in which direction we should be looking? Anything you want to warn me about before you produce the next parrot out of your hat? Nasty things, parrots. Smell like rotting lilac flowers.
Mm-hmm.
master tonight, Bernie. You're waiting for the Big Bang? I thought you might be working on her over there's files. She had a sneeze and went home early. Dickie. Well, it usually means that something's cropped up he can't cope with.
Julian.
From the KGB. You're my goodbye contact.
Ten, old son. It's not your fault.
KGB?
No.
Made to look like KGB?
Something like that.
What do we do about Klestikov?
Pull him in. Never know your luck. Someone might loosen his tongue. Show us who the other mole might be.
Which I suppose could be me. Why not?
Well, no slur on your abilities, Dickie, but...
We know it can't be you.
Why not?
You know the identity of Brahms Thor, the mole doesn't. Isn't that the whole point of what's going on?
Giles Trent wasn't the mole.
No.
Brahms IV sent one final communication on the goodbye code. He indicated he had the means to identify the second mole in London.
How?
The mole sent some handwritten reports, or Bank of England stuff. Something destined to end up on Brahms' desk.
Handwritten pages, right?
Deliberate. The mole's shown himself, Bernie. Now he's waiting for you to go in and get those sheets of paper and show in turn who Brahms IV is to the KGB. You're going to have to go over the wire, whether you like it or not. For your friend Brahms, Bernie. Not for Brett.
On the strength of handwritten pages, Frank?
Have you heard from Rolf Mauser?
No.
Brahms 1 is out.
So how do you know?
Through Bogman.
Through Zena, you mean?
I knew you tracked her down, Bernard. She was hopping mad.
She was hopping mad?
Oh, I'm not complaining, it was your job. I just like to think that any business I have with Zena is kept out of the official files.
Is that why you came over to London to tell me that?
Of course it bloody well isn't. I never breach security with anyone, Daddy. You should damn well know that.
Pillow talk has a habit of saying things you don't even realize you're saying.
And it's overreact.
I'm not overreacting, Frank. I'm going to be the one that's on the wrong side of Charlie, right? Picking other people's chestnuts out of the fire. And I just want to make damn sure that Mrs. Zena Volkman does not know my travel plans, okay?
You're saying you don't trust me? For God's sake, Bernard, this is Frank Harrington you're talking to. I promised your father I'd look after you. I promised that when you joined the department. I promised again at the very end. If you're going over the wire, the first time in 6 years, you're going over my way or not at all.
I notice you don't say much about getting me back again.
Someone else. I haven't even been to bed yet.
Giles Trent's been shot dead.
By whom?
No idea.
What happens now?
It's your chess game, isn't it? Pieces on the board. I know.
Work. They never stop, and they are hardly ever checked, not at the crossing. High wages for the driver, and hard currency for the East.
Mm-hmm. How long does it take to set up?
One phone call. It's always been my private goodbye road, if anything went badly wrong.
Never been used before.
You worried your mole in London might know about it, or you don't trust me anymore. Max Binder swam the river. Winkle made a run for it, and Rolf Mauser disappeared. Brahms' network is folding up.
Rolf Mauser has been shooting people in London. With the help of my money, and no doubt your advice.
An airplane ticket. That's all I gave him.
Yes, well, I gave him £400 he needed to buy a gun. And if anybody in London...
We are all frightened your mole in London going to dump them.
Don't frighten your little black market racket is about to be uncovered by the Stasis of Opus or the KGB.
Not my racket, Bernie. By the time I found out about it, it was too late. All I could do was try to keep them out of danger.
Is that why you pimped Zena to Frank Harrington? To keep him off your backs? Why didn't you tell me you knew where she was?
And have you think she was knocking off with Frank Harrington? Zeno was doing an undercover job for Frank. The place in Lübers is a safe house.
Is that what she told you?
She's come back to me, Bernie. And it was you who got us back together. You frightened her.
Did you know she was in Lübers?
Okay. Who said that sometimes? It's terrible to find an enemy in the friend. But it's much worse not to find the friend in the friend. Who's coming over?
It's a dustbin job.
They sent you back here for the garbage, do they? Then why is Frank Harrington moving you east? Is it Brahms 4?
There's no need for you to know.
Oh, yes, there is. That's my private road, buddy. You only use a good ones once. I'd like to be sure it's for someone you really need to get out.
Brahms 4.
And who's Brahms 4?
Nobody knows.
You know.
So will you tomorrow.
That's your man. He'll pull out of the run to change your wheel. There's an overhead warehouse crane where he will stop. The coffin gets dropped in there. The sand loader's been paid. He shoots the sand in over the coffin. He also makes sure the sand gets watered down. There's just one check about a mile before the wall. If the sand's wet, the infrared won't pick up body heat through the lead coffin.
How big's the coffin?
Will be a tight fit for two. And only one oxygen mask.
Right, you're back on the payroll for 24 hours.
Whose authorization?
Mine.
Your payroll again?
For the moment.
London?
I want you back in East Berlin before the checkpoints close tomorrow night. The worst comes to the worst. Things are going to move very quickly over there, and I'm going to be on the wrong side of the wall. I need your help, buddy.
Stadtmitte.
Yes. There's a maintenance shop up to the upper level.
The last man through would have been a little careless with the lock.
How did you manage that?
Charm. And pretty young girls.
Cheers, Frank.
Good luck, laddie.
Streichart. Deine Papiere. Zeig mir deine Papiere.
Didn't take you long to catch up. You're a brave and a stupid man. What does it feel like to be back in the field?
How should it feel?
For you, dangerous. How did you come over? Forget I asked, but you're sweating still from the cold. You come to see your Brahms Four to tell him it's all right now, yes? I could have done that for you, Bernd.
If you're looking for the gun, I dropped it in the river. I had to bring you Mr. Trent round the corner, Bernd. He was going to blow the whole Brahms network.
You murdered him, Rolf.
He was going to betray all of us, the whole Berlin system.
Giles Trent didn't know Brahms' network from a Mozart piano concerto.
Then why did Max Binder run?
Because he was on the game with all of you.
But why all the questions and checks?
Because someone guessed, or knew, that I'd set up the network. Which, of course, is when they found out whatever black market racket it was that you were all running together. That's why Max had to bolt, Rolf.
Trent was leaking to the KGB. When he found me in his room, he thought I was his contact.
We wanted him to go on leaking. It's called disinformation, Rolf. You killed the wrong bloody man and left your prints all over me.
I was trying to help you.
Bait.
He was an agent. How was I to know that you turned him?
Giles Trent was nobody.
So I killed the wrong man.
From the KGB. You're my goodbye contact, that's what he said. He wasn't even afraid of me. Do you bait a line in London because you have a second spy? Is that why you're here? Because Brahms 4 will tell you who is the second spy? You know what I think? I think tomorrow, when you go to see your Brahms 4, you will find that he's been dead for 10 years and the KGB been pulling our legs all this time.
You'd love to know who he was, wouldn't you? Carrying his messages for 15 years, never seeing his face.
You will need some help tomorrow, Bernd.
If you're going to tell me I've been away too long, sitting at a desk in London, I'll strangle you.
That is true.
Thank you, everybody. Boring old lunch at Santini's, dear. Lubricating the Home Office.
Any news from Berlin?
Oh, do stop worrying, Fiona. He'll be all right. He's got our full backup.
That makes me feel a whole lot happier.
Brandy's done a bunk, Fiona.
He hasn't been over the wall for 5 years, Dickie. That's what frightens me.
So bitte, wir unterbrechen jetzt für ein paar Minuten und jeder widmet sich noch einmal seinen schwierigen Stellen. Und dann bringen wir meinem Freund hier eine konzertreife Darbietung. They're wondering why I had to practice on a Thursday afternoon. They probably believe you are a famous Russian impresario. 15 years playing quintets with them, and all for this moment, our one meeting. It means your system has worked very well, Barnett. Is it a bad sign they have sent you?
You asked for me.
I ask for you because I feel you will not betray me. That does not mean to say you will do what I want you to do. You had courage to come back.
You saved my life in Weimar, Walter. Perhaps I've been waiting 15 years to say thank you.
It is a lonely business, and I've been left alone on my own, Barnett. It has its effect, I'm afraid. I know what you have come to ask me. Twice already I've done that. Silas Gaunt sends me smoked salmon and Stilton and asks me to hang on for another year. I'm too old, Barnett. I cannot take the being afraid all the time. No more can my wife. Whoever it is in London, something has been said, here or in Moscow. I can almost feel them begin to close in.
You say you can identify this, whoever it is in London? Have you brought the evidence with you?
That is my bargain, Barnett. My conditions. You get me and my wife out, and I'll bring the evidence with me. I'm tired. It doesn't work no longer to believe it will happen sometimes in the future.
What is this evidence of yours?
4 pages of handwriting.
A handwritten report? A Soviet agent breaking all the rules?
Deliberately. It was a minutes of a meeting between Bank of England and Cabinet Office. Bound to end up on my desk sooner or later. At which point I call for you, as I've done. And the KGB hope to catch the two of us before you get me and the evidence out over the wall. They'll be looking for you today all over Berlin. Your mole in London still, she doesn't know my real identity. It is the handwriting of a woman. I'm sorry. We only have these 2 hours to practice. I think I should pretend everything is normal today.
Walter, I need to phone London.
Use office up the corridor. The privilege of rank, even for amateur musicians. Dial 5 and then the number. You'll be listening. Be discreet. Okay.
Treason has done his worst. Our worst.
Where are you? How long have I got? Me, Betty. They'll be coming out of school in 10 minutes.
It is sad I cannot say goodbye to them as I would have liked to. Next week, they will know I was a traitor. What will happen to me on the other side?
You'll be flown directly to England in an RAF plane. No formalities, Walter.
And then?
Place in the country while they debrief you.
Du, Walter, ich gehe jetzt.
Will I see Silas?
Oh, he'll be there, I'm sure.
Bis demnächst, eh?
Ja, ich auch. Ne? Okay, dann. Wiedersehen, Walter. Bis dann. Bis zum nächsten Mal, Walter. Tschüss.
Strange how now the time has come. I almost hesitate. It is frightening to leave everything behind. So many years of your life. All of your life. And to be able to take so little with you. Was ist eigentlich los? You know who it is, the woman with the handwriting. Mein Gott, es ist deine Frau. Mrs. Sampson.
You must admit, Walter, this whole business does have its funny side. You sent for me all the way over here because you trust me. And then we discover that my wife is the defector.
I don't think there's any funny side. Not for you, Bernd. You are on the wrong side of the world to suddenly discover your wife is a defector. The first time in 5 years, they sent you back into the East, and now you have to tell them your wife is KGB. You have told them on telephone?
I couldn't get through. It's time to try again.
You have no urgency?
Like you said, Walter, I'm on the wrong side of the war.
Thank you.
that's enough for this afternoon. Oh, no, it's all right. Leave it, leave it. Cryer, Dickie Cryer.
Samson.
Bernard? Where the hell are you? I thought you were supposed to...
Dickie, listen. I have identified the mole.
Security, Bernard, security.
Fiona Samson.
For Christ's sake, Bernard, Fiona runs the yellow submarine. She can't be the leak.
The children have been taken to my mother's. They'll need protection. My mother's house, Dickie. They'll be going for the children.
What do you expect me to do?
I don't think you should sleep at home tonight. Bring your wife and tell her to meet you somewhere.
We have a laube out in Buchholz, a little summer house on an allotment.
Tomorrow you come into the offices if everything was normal. Bring photocopies of the handwritten pages, meet me on the lake. You know the quarries?
And my wife?
I'll bring your wife. Just tell her to stay in the laube tomorrow until I come.
I wish I could think of something to say.
You know what people say in the East? Why can't the damned Nazis come back to look after their roads? It's an old joke. Have you documents?
I'll be all right, as long as it's not the Stasi or the KGB.
Looks like traffic, not starters.
Look at them. Obsessed with uniform. These people never will change.
Where's the gallery then, Walter?
It's near there. And it's not a place to get trapped down.
You be careful too, Walter.
Miles, 6.5 hours in the air. Five border crossings. 44 minutes late.
We picked the children up from the school.
I met your London colleague in a school playground. I looked round at the other man. He looked round at the other man. Looked like sexual perverts. And your nanny thought we were both kidnappers. The real kidnappers arrived 1/2 minute too late. Time things close, Bernie.
They're safe at your mother's.
Got it.
Armed guards. And Dickie Cryer. He looked puzzled.
It's going to be bad tomorrow.
Was it Fiona?
Yes.
Ach, du großer.
Probably. Ever since I came through the checkpoint.
Major Erich Dennis, KGB Berlin Office.
Fiona's first victim.
Shouting to warn you off. That means they know you are here, Bernie.
Still waiting for us to lead them to Brahms. You tread very carefully tomorrow, my friend. He's gonna need your help.
Bound to know we're here.
Where's Walter?
Waiting by the lake with his four sheets of paper.
What happened?
They're the Stasi's front and back as soon as he put them in the photocopy machine. Your Dr. Walter von Munter's a very cool man. He had his escape planned.
We're running out of time. No, you take these to England. Give them to Silas.
You're not coming with us?
Don't worry about me. I'll find a way back. Makes us all square for Weimar.
I'm sorry, Bernd. The way it happened for you.
Come.
Scheiße.
Follow that track as fast as you can. They'll be waiting for you.
Viel Glück.
Alles klar?
Halben Stunde ist es wieder draußen. Viel Glück. Viel Glück, Walter. Toi, toi, toi.
Going over. Car, truck, train, or with a tourist bus through Checkpoint Charlie. Your head, Dr. Walter von Monte. If he reaches the West in safety, I don't think you will ever see the sunshine again. Ah, yet, yet. No hands on you, they told me, Sukinsen. I wonder who protects you so carefully. Don't worry about your Herr Dr. von Munte. We caught him an hour ago.
I think we can give up this charade. The only thing that matches with your files is a photograph. It's a strain, isn't it, having to remember identification stories?
We used to spend weeks on that in training. The invention of stories and foreign languages. My specialization, Latin America. It's a bloody nightmare.
Perhaps you wouldn't mind telling me why there's been no serious attempt to interrogate me.
Not to make an advantage of your state of mind. We should have been interrogating for 5 hours while you were warm. Or to be more precise, cold. Frightened cold, Mr. Sampson. But instead I was overruled by some KGB colonel. Some party bastard sitting behind his fat desk. You know what it's like. We both work the tough side of the business.
Major?
Major Erich Stinnes, KGB Berlin office. Mrs. Sampson, SIS, late of London Central. Yes, my wife, Major Stinnes. Mother of my children.
The children were picked up at your mother's last night, after Vern had left.
Then you may need this.
It's going to cause you a lot of trouble back at London Central, that telephone call. Sentimental, really. Thank you. You will be going home.
Cut the style a bit, will it? Having your husband down the end of the road?
I've made it a condition that you should have access to the children.
Access? Where?
In Moscow, I'm afraid. Berlin's too close to the border. And too full of your school chums.
Safe passage?
I can protect you there.
How long have you been protecting me?
You haven't needed it for
how long, Fiona? God, what a perfect cover I was for you. Every time I came back from the East, silent. sigh, your little sigh of relief. Pat me on the head, tell me how brave I was. Put your arms around me. Make me feel warm and safe. Jesus Christ. How many lives have you made me live?
The relief was genuine. I suppose I should say I'm glad the pretending is all over. I hope you'll do everything you can to make things easy for the children.
Rather depends who's got them, doesn't it?
They're waiting for me in Moscow.
Apparently for me in London. I wonder what would have happened if your little gamble had come off. You'd have been able to carry on, I suppose. You had to have got rid of me, though. How long, Fiona? How long have you been spying?
I've had my own private goodbye plan for every hour of every day and night. You're being swapped.
Why?
You're more used to me back there. And there's nothing you can tell them here that I can't tell them. Besides, you always were very good at stirring the mud. I wouldn't want Dickie and Brett to have too easy a time. But don't ask me.
You love me because you were told to.
I expect you'll want to sleep. You'll have a bed.
Sorry, Bernard.
Save it, Frank. Where are the kids?
With your mother.
How do you know?
I talked to them an hour ago on the phone.
Poor Fiona.
Poor Fiona?
Did Brahms make it?
Yes.
And his wife?
Uh-huh.
Let's go home.
making sure that MI5 stay within the parameters of decency, Bernard. And within the limits of their brief.
That's very thoughtful of you, Brad.
Well, I can leave you to keep an eye on them yourself now. Your nanny had to go home. See her own family. Doris will be looking after you for a while.
Why are they doing that?
Oh, I expect your daddy must have lost something.
Excuse me. While the kids are here, okay? If you want to play hide-and-seek, you wait till they're at school. Out.
Len Deighton's trilogy is available in hardback and paperback from bookshops.
This episode of Game, Set and Match can be seen again this Saturday night at 8:05 on Channel 4.